Hi, this week's Roundup sees quite a few robotics products, along with some fairly interesting desktop manufacturing devices. This week on Kickstarter.
You know how a lot of campaigns start with world's first blah blah blah? Well, this one is one of the few that can claim that title. Holy Toledo, Batman, a desktop waterjet cutter. I just hope they've sorted out any leakage problems. This one has 59 days to go and is already four times over their goal. This is the point at which a lot of great companies fail, where they overcommit. If you're into 3D printing, then this looks interesting. Its primary purpose is to avoid warping of prints that can occur with other platforms. You can also throw away your tape. Supports any type of filament. Cool. If you want to get into robotics, then this Kickstarter will give you a hand, literally. It's a low-cost robotic hand built from 3D printed parts, using cables and a single servo per digit to mimic a human hand more accurately. We'll set you back $175 for one hand. A Frisbee that's hackable? Cool. This is a nice little product aimed at teaching kids to code up some games with the Frisbee. Wonder if it's childproof. This next one is a great idea, but one to be careful of. It's basically an attempt to standardize home automation by providing an open hardware platform which contains Wi-Fi, capacitive touch, and a triac capable of switching up to 15 amps. They have a tough road ahead of them. There are a lot of hoops they need to jump through to meet all the worldwide standards, and they vary from country to country.
Last week, I didn't include some of the Indiegogo campaigns, so here's a couple I missed out.
Hey, if you missed the Kickstarter campaign, you have some time to pick up an Amiga 2 from Indiegogo. Go and get one. This next one is pretty cool for STEM students. It's essentially an Arduino board and sensor shield supporting Grove, but the intent is to provide a complete STEM package for students to get into coding. Nice. Next one is Brixo, a Lego-style building block. That is, it's 1,434% funded. Wow. It provides three modules, trigger, connector, and action block. The trigger blocks can be Bluetooth, or sound, light, and proximity sensors, while action blocks can be lights or motors. This one is really nice, and no surprise it's over 1,400% funded. Keeping on with the theme of learning, the IQube attempts to teach electronics by removing all the soldering. You just magnetically connect blocks together to form your circuits, and it interacts with your smartphone or PC. You have a variety of input and output cubes to choose from. The next four are robotic products. STEMI is a hexapod robot controlled from your smartphone. Then there's Marty the Robot. Then Ganker, aimed at people wanting to fight each other, or at least get their robots to do it for them. And Ziro, which is controlled just by waving your hands around. This next one is a sensor board for the Pi. It seems to be attracting a lot of interest, except from backers. Not sure why, but it gives you a whole bunch of sensors that would add up to a lot more than buying individually. Oh look, a world's first plug-and-play wearable platform. So why is it the world's first? Oh, I see here. They are providing a super thin cable that plugs into the board instead of using e-textile conductive thread. That's a good idea. Wonder though if the cable was washable. Holy Toledo, Batman. Desktop injection moulding? Fantastic. Yes, I agree 3D printing is too slow for production runs, but usually injection moulding tooling is quite finicky and hard to get right. But this guy seems to have come up with something that works. If you're a fan of the ESP8266, then this will make you drool. If you haven't already heard, the ESP3212 based modules have been in production runs for quite a while now, and you can get your hands on, finally, a seed module. The ESP3212 now has Bluetooth 4.2, 16 meg flash, SD card interface, capacitive touch, and an Xtensa LX6 dual-core MCU. Have I got you drooling yet? Well, the planned shipping date is the 25th of October currently, and I'd say they're going to run out of that batch as well. Get it while it's hot.
So that's it for this week. I've put links to everything in the description below and also on my website. Let me know if I've missed anything out. If you're not a subscriber already, you can support me by subscribing. And if you enjoyed this video, don't forget to like. Thanks for watching, and see you next week.